Good morning. Today we are going to discuss how to dispose of healthcare waste in landfills during the COVID-19 crisis. Why we need to discuss this? Because during the pandemics, healthcare waste is another potential source of infections. So we have to make sure that they are safely and properly collected, treated, and disposed of. Another additional problem we have during the crisis is that during the pandemics, despite of the usual practice to separate hospital waste in infectious and non-infectious, we usually consider all the hospital waste as infectious, applying the precautionary principle. So, what we have to make sure is that advanced and increased quantities of healthcare waste comparing to normal periods have to be treated and disposed of safely. Sometimes in developed countries, this means that part of the healthcare waste cannot be absorbed by the healthcare waste treatment units and it has to be disposed of in landfills. On the other side, in developing countries, in many cases, we have a lack of healthcare waste treatment systems, so landfills are once again the final sink for this type of infectious waste. Disposal in landfills has to be done in a certain way. This is the subject of our discussion today. Before we go further, we have to remember that healthcare waste involves serious hazards like, first, presence of infectious agents. Second, genotoxic or cytotoxic chemical composition. Third, presence of toxic or hazardous chemicals. Fourth, possibly presence of biologically aggressive pharmaceuticals. Fifth, possibly radioactivity. And finally, in many cases, used SARPs. We have to make sure that all the workers in the landfill are protected by these hazards. So informing them about the disposal of waste, of healthcare waste, is a very important element before anything else. So, how to start? Rule number one, the safer, the better. This means that if there is no thermal treatment available for our healthcare waste, then our first option is to dispose them off in a sanitary landfill, a landfill that has been properly constructed and operated with all the environmental pollution control measures of a sanitary landfill. If such a sanitary landfill is not available, at least we have to find out what we call an engineered landfill, a landfill with some, but not all, the elements that determine the environmental protection measures of a sanitary landfill. In any case, we want to avoid to put our healthcare waste in a dump site. This must be a certain restriction to all our movements. Rule number two, no contact. Our main purpose during the disposal of healthcare waste in landfills is to ensure that first, waste workers will not be at risk during the disposal activities. And second, once the healthcare waste is dumped, no human or animal will be able to contact with them. And, of course, rule number three, we should not dispose of healthcare waste with the usual landfill operations. In case healthcare waste is brought to the disposal site, first, waste workers should be informed and take special precautions, if possible, like wearing masks and gloves. Second, in any case, workers should keep a distance and avoid any direct contact with the waste. And third, the waste should be unloaded as close as possible to the dumping area, which means we don't want to unload the waste far away from the tipping area and transfer it again, because the wind might blow it away. And fourth, we have to dump the waste immediately after unloading. We don't want infectious waste to stuck in piles waiting to be dumped for hours, because this is a source of infection for animals, birds, and humans as well, especially in the case there are scavengers. Now, let's move to rule number 4. The general principle for dumping healthcare waste in landfills is go in depth and isolate. There are 4 ways to do it. First, to put healthcare waste in the daily tipping area. Second, to use an old part of the landfill. Third, to create a special burial pit for healthcare waste. And fourth, to encapsulate it. We're gonna speak about these 4 ways in details. Let's start with the first way, to put the waste in the tipping area. In this case, we go to the tipping area where we have our daily operations, and we should excavate a shallow hollow on the bottom of the tipping area. We should fill it with healthcare waste, cover it with soil, and on top of it, we should build the new waste layers at least 2 meters high. In this way, make sure that healthcare waste is not on the top of the surface, so it's not easy to be scavenged. And we have to make sure that scavengers do not have access to this particular part of the tipping area. If you want to find more details about landfill operations and guidelines, please visit ISVA's website and find the new ISVA landfill operation guidelines that were published in 2019, as shown in this particular link. The second way is to use an old part of the landfill. In this case, we are trying to find a place on top of mature waste up to 3 months old. We excavate a 2 meters deep trench and backfill it with healthcare waste. Be sure that you don't put healthcare waste more than 0.5 or 1 meter below the surface. So what's left, this 0.5 or 1 meter, should be covered with the excavated mature waste. And then, on top of it, we can put again soil. Again, we have to make sure that this area will not be accessed by scavengers. The third way is to create a special burial pit. In this case, first of all, we have to find an area inside the landfill and isolate it, preferably by a special fence. A typical way to construct it is to excavate a 2 meters deep pit and start putting healthcare waste in layers, putting soil on top of each layer immediately after their disposal. So, in a way, we isolate them. If you have lime, add it. It's going to be beneficially for protecting the environment and reducing the risks for infections. Then backfill the pit until maximum 0.5 meters below the surface and fill the final 50 centimeters with soil. Again, we fence the area to make sure that scavengers do not have access there to protect them from infectious waste. A fourth way is what we call encapsulation. You have to find a metal or a plastic container and fill it up to three-fourths of it with waste. Then, the last part of it, roughly one-fourth, should be filled using a medium like plastic foam, bituminous sand, cement mortar, or clay, just to make sure that the container is sealed. After the medium is dried, we can dispose the containers in the landfill with the usual landfill operations, again, preferably in the bottom of the daily cell. So, allow me to recap the 4 rules we learned. Rule number 1, the safer the better, which means that if we want to dispose healthcare waste in a landfill, a sanitary landfill is always preferable, and dump sites should be, in any case, avoided. Rule number 2, no contact. workers and scavengers should not be in contact with healthcare waste during the disposal operations. Rule number three, no business as usual, which means that certain procedures should be applied to dispose of healthcare waste safely in a sanitary landfill. And rule number four, go deep and isolate the healthcare waste, so in any case, it will not be possible for someone to scavenge it and for animals to contact it. Allow me to finish with a comment about landfills and pandemics. Sanitary landfills are an indispensable part of any waste management system. Despite the fact that many countries have official policies to close sanitary landfills, finally, there is always a residue that has to be disposed of in sanitary landfills. In pandemics, especially in the absence of thermal treatment for healthcare waste, sanitary landfills are a safe final sink for healthcare waste, but certain procedures, as you explained, have to be applied. But even if thermal treatment for infectious waste is available, in pandemics, usually healthcare waste is much more than usual, so sanitary landfills can provide an alternative disposal route. Last but not least, the International Solid Waste Association has the biggest online library of waste management documents. So go to our knowledge base in this link, just put your email and you can have access to more than 4,000 documents available. At least 150 of them are relevant to healthcare and medical waste. Thank you very much and stay tuned.